Hello everybody and welcome back to yet another video. My name is Nawri Radwan and you are tuned to Photo Manipulation YouTube channel. In this video, I will show you how to add that steam effect on the glass material. And without any further ado, let's start with this tutorial. If you are wondering when this technique comes to use, usually it comes to use when you are working on turning a scene from being a normal scene to a rainy scene. So just to give an example, if I want to turn this scene from this to this, small details like that add some realism to your work. So first I'm going to click Shift Control Alt E to merge all of the layers at the top. Then I will go to Filter, Blur, and I will add Gaussian Blur. I will add a radius value of 50. I want it to be blurred too much. Next, I will add a new layer. I will paint it black, or I will fill it with the black color. Next, click on Filter, Render, and then choose Fibers. On the Fibers menu, make sure the variance is beneath 20% or 20 value. So I will keep it at, let's say, 15. On the Strength, make sure it's all the way up to its maximum, which is 64. Next step, click on Filter, Filter Gallery, and then go to Distort. Click on Glass, and as you can see, this is the effect that it added. Here's the settings on the right side. The distortion is on 15, the smoothness is on 15, the texture is canvas, and the scaling is on the maximum, which is 200%. Now, this settings might be different with the image size of the image that you are working on, but if you don't get the same results, just start changing these settings until you get something like that. Let me zoom out so you can see the full effect, and then I will click on OK. I will click and hold Ctrl T, that's the free transformation shortcut, and then increase the width and the height. I will increase them to 400% both. Then I will select the image by clicking and holding Ctrl A. This will select the canvas or select all. Click on image and then click on crop. Click on Ctrl M. That will bring the curves menu and then make a harsh contrast between the blacks and the whites. Then click on filter, blur, and then click on Gaussian blur. Give it a blur value that makes sure not to mess the effect. We just want to get rid of these pixelated edges. Click on Ctrl T for the free transformation, then increase the height. Now click Ctrl A to select the whole canvas, then Ctrl C to copy, and then click on Q to enter the standard mode or the select mode. If the layer turns to red, that means you are on the standard mode. So click Ctrl V to paste, and then click Q again to exit the standard mode. Now we have a selection of that white spots. Let's click on the blurred image of the car, and then I will add it as a layer. And then I will click on Ctrl I to invert the mask. As you can see, that added effect of the raindrops on the glass. To make it even more realistic, what I will do right here is I will click on the first layer right here. And I will select it again on the Q, which is the quick standard mode. Then I will add an empty layer, click on Shift F5, and then I will fill it with 50% gray. Now we have this gray color on the raindrops areas. Next, change the blending mode from normal to even soft light or overlay. I will go for the soft light. As you can see right here, the gray color has vanished. It's no longer showing on the screen. Click two times on that layer and then add a bevel and emboss. Now what I want to achieve here is a look of the rain, or how the rain will reflect the light. To do that, I will change these settings right here. I will change the angle, the altitude, and this curve right here. First, let's start with the curve and let's see what will work for us the best. These are the settings that work for me. If you don't get the same result, you can change all of these effects right here or these options. Make sure the highlight mode is on overlay, the shadow mode is on darken, and decrease it. The size, make sure it's all the way down to 2. The soften is all the way down to 1 pixels, and the depth is all the way up to its maximum, which is 1000%. For the direction right here, you can change up or down, and that will be the light direction. Next, I will add the raindrops. To do that, add an empty layer, fill it with black color, click on filter, pixelate, and click on mesotint. On the type right here, select medium dots. Give them a little bit of blur, maybe 5 pixels or 4, it will be okay. Then click on Control M, that will bring the curves adjustment and add a harsh contrast. Click Control T, that will be the free transformation. Then click and hold Shift Alt, then click on one point right here on the side and drag it to the right side. Just to increase the scale, click Ctrl A to select the canvas, then image, crop. To get rid of the black background, click 2 times on the layer. Take this slide of the current layer right here on the blend if to the right side. Then click and hold Alt, and then take the half and drag it away from the first half. Click OK. Then right click on the layer, convert it to smart object, and then rasterize the layer. Click Ctrl U and make it black by decreasing the lightness all the way down to -100, then click OK. Click Ctrl U again, and then add the lightness by 10% or 10 pixels, maybe more. Let's make sure it's a faded black. Now, increase the fill right here, that's beneath the opacity, all the way down to 10%. Click 2 times on that layer and add bevel and emboss. Right here, you want to add a different settings from the first one, because these ones are supposed to be the raindrops. So let's give them a look that looks like a raindrop. I think this one right here looks good. These are the settings for it, and I will click OK. Now, I don't want the raindrops to cover all of the screen, so what I will do here, I will add a mask. Then I will go to Filter, or click on Filter, Render, Add Clouds. Click right here on the middle on that lock icon to remove the lock between the layer and the mask. Click on the mask, then click Ctrl T and scale it up or increase the scale. Click Ctrl A and then go to image and crop it. Click on the mask, click Ctrl L, that will bring the levels menu, and then add a contrast. Now we don't have the raindrops all covering the screen, it's just spreaded on some random areas. Apply the mask. Now let's add the final touch, which is a steam. So let's add a new empty layer, fill it with black. Then click on Filter, Render, click on Clouds. Click Ctrl T, increase the width and the height to like 5%, 5% or 700%, sorry, I'm not good with the numbers, of course. Now let's crop it. Let's click on Ctrl A to select the canvas, click Ctrl C to copy, and then click on Q to enter the standard mode or the quick mask mode, which will turn the layer to this red color. Click Ctrl V to paste, then click Q to exit the standard mode. Now while these clouds are selected, add it as a mask to the clouds layer. Go to Filter while clicking on the mask, then click on Filter Gallery. Then go to Texture and add Grain. Then click OK. Apply that layer mask, click Control U to get this hue and saturation menu and increase the lightness all the way up. Then click on Control U again and decrease the lightness just a bit. Give it a color that looks like the mode of the image, which I will add a color lockup. On the 3D LUT file, I will select Moonlight again. Apply it on that clouds layer and increase the opacity to 30%. And I will change the blending mode to green. Decrease the opacity to 50%. And this is how you add this window effect. You can always go back to that mask right here and decrease or increase the size of that rain on the window, just like that, by clicking Control T and then increasing and decreasing the scale by dragging that point. Now let's apply that same effect on the car windows or the windshield. Also, there is an extra fun step which you can do. After you add the blurred image or the blurred layer and you get this texture on the mask, you can add hue and saturation adjustment layer at the top and clip it to the layer. Add lightness, and then you can write or draw whatever you want right here, as if you are drawing on a mirror. Make it more realistic. You will paint with a black color brush that's set to dissolve blending mode. Now let's make a speed run on the techniques or the steps that we covered. So first I will select the windshield. Next I will click on Control J to make a copy of that windshield and then click on layer, go to layer mask, then choose from transparency. Make a copy of that layer. On the first layer right here or the top layer, click on the mask, right click and then click on apply layer mask. And then click and hold Alt, then take that mask to the top mask. And now let's just delete this one because we don't need it. Let's make another copy and let's keep this one as a backup. Let's remove the connection between the layer and the mask by clicking on that lock icon. Next, go to Filter, Blur and add Gaussian Blur. Then click OK. Let's decrease the opacity just a bit. Now let's make the textures. Now let's click on Control A, Control C to copy, then Q to enter the quick mask mode, Control V to paste, and then Q to exit the quick mask mode. Select the selection tool, right click on the screen, then click on transform selection. Let's decrease the scale of it. Let's take it to the car and change the perspective. This one already looks good. To make it even better, I will click on Control L and add contrast. Make it more visible. Just like that. Let's add now the raindrops. Let's add a mask to that raindrops. Let's add clouds. Let's remove the connection. Increase the size of the clouds. Let's add contrast. Next, let's add a clouds texture. Let's apply the windshield effect on it, or the mask, sorry. And let's increase the height of that texture, just like that. Change the blending mode from normal to soft light and increase the opacity to 40%. This is it for today's tutorial. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you learned something new. If you did, show me that by clicking on the like button. Also subscribe to this channel. I will see you in the next tutorials. Peace.